the story of the second Sheikh and the two black hounds. Then said the Sheikh, "Now, O Lord of the kings of the Jinn, that these two hounds are my brothers. My father died and left us 3,000 pieces of gold, and I opened a shop to sell and buy. But one of my brothers made a journey with a stock of merchandise and was absent from us for the space of a year with the caravans, after which he returned destitute. I said to him, 'Did I not advise thee to abstain from traveling?' But he wept and said, 'O my brother, God, to whom he ascribed all might and glory, decreed this event, and there is no longer any profit in these words. I have nothing left.' So I took him up into the shop and then went him to the bath and clad him in a costly suit of my own clothing, after which we sat down together to eat. And I said to him, 'O my brother, I will calculate the game of my shop during the year and divide it, exclusive of the principal, between me and thee.' Accordingly, I made the calculation and found my gain to amount in 2,000 pieces of gold, and I praised God, to whom he ascribed all might and glory, and rejoiced exceedingly and divided the gain in 2 equal parts between myself and him. My other brother then set forth on a journey, and after a year returned in the like condition, and I did unto him as I have done to the former. After this, when we had lived together for some time, my brothers again wished to travel, and were desirous that I should accompany him, but I would not. 'What said I have gained in your travels that I should expect to gain?' They importuned me, but I would not comply with their request, and we remained selling and buying in our shops of whole year. Still, however, they persevered in proposing that we should travel, and I still refused, until after the lapse of 6 entire years, when at last I consented and said to them, 'O my brothers, let us calculate what property we possess.' We did so and found it to be 6,000 pieces of gold. And I then said to them, 'We will bury half of it in the earth. Then it may be of service to us if any misfortune befall us, in which case each of us shall take 1,000 pieces with which to traffic.' 'Excellent is the advice,' said they. So I took the money and divided it into 2 equal portions and buried 3,000 pieces of gold, and of the other half I gave to each of them 1,000 pieces. We then prepared merchandise, and I hired a ship and embarked our goods and proceeded on our voyage for the space of a whole month, at the expiration of which we arrived at the city, where we sold our merchandise, and for every piece of gold we gained then. And when we were about to set sail again, we found on the shore of the sea a maiden clad in tattered garments, who kissed my hand and said to me, 'O my master, art thou possessed of charity and kindness? If so, I will requite thee for them.' I answered, 'Yes, I have those qualities, though thou requite me not.' Then said she, 'O my master, accept me as thy wife and take me to the country, for I give myself to thee.' act kindly towards me, for I am one who require to be treated with kindness and charity, and who will require thee for so doing, and let not my present condition at all deceive thee. When I heard these words, my heart was moved with tenderness towards her in order to the accomplishment of a purpose of God, to whom he ascribed all might and glory. And I took her and clothed her and furnished for her the place in the ship in a handsome manner and regarded her with kind and respectful attention. We then set sail and I became most cordially attached to my wife, so that on her account I neglected the society of my brothers, who in consequence became jealous of me and likewise envied me my wealth and the abundance of my merchandise, casting their eyes of covetous consequences became upon the whole of the property. They therefore consulted together to kill me and take my wealth, saying, "Let us kill our brother, and all the property shall be ours." And the devil made these actions to seem fair in their eyes. So they came to my while I was sleeping by the side of my wife, and took both of us up and threw us into the sea. But as soon as my wife awoke, she shook herself and became transformed into a chimney. She immediately bore me away and placed me upon an island, and for a while disappeared. In the morning, however, she returned and said to me, "I am the wife who carried thee and rescued thee from death by permission of God, whose name be exalted. Now that I am a chimney, I saw thee, and my heart loved thee for the sake of God, for I am a believer in God and his apostle. God bless and save him. I came to thee in the condition in which thou sawest me, and thou didst marry me, and see, I have rescued thee from drowning. But I am incensed against thy brothers, and I must kill them." When I heard her tale, I was astonished, and thanked her for what she had done. But said I, "As to the destruction of my brothers, it was not my desire." I then related to her all that happened between myself and them from first to last. And when she had heard it, she said, "I will the next night fly to them and sink their ship and destroy them." But I said, "I conjure thee by Allah that thou do it not. For the author of the proverb said, 'Of thou benefactor of him who had done evil, the action that thou hath done is sufficient for him. Besides, they are all events my brothers.'" She still, however, said, "They must be killed." And I continued to propitiate her towards them. And at the last, she lifted me up and soared through the air and placed me on the roof of my house. Having opened the doors, I dug up which I had hidden in the earth, and after I had saluted my neighbors and bought merchandise, I opened my shop, and in the following night, when I entered my house, I found these two dogs tied up in it, and as soon as they saw me, they came to me and wept and clung to me, but I knew not what had happened until immediately my wife appeared before me. She said, "These are their brothers." "And who?" said, "I hath done this into them." She answered, "I sent to my sister, and she did it. And they shall not be restored until after the lapse of 10 years. And I was now on my way to her, that she might restore them, as they have been in this state 10 years. And I saw this man, and being informed of what had befallen him, I determined not to quit the place until I should have seen what would happen between thee and him. This is my story. Verily, said the jinn, it's a wonderful tale, and I give up to the tea a third of the claim that they had to his blood on account of his offence. Upon this, the third sheikh, the owner of the mule, said to Jim, as to me, break not my heart if I relate to thee nothing more than this.